You are listening to I Am Refocused Radio with your host, Shamaya Reed. This show is designed to inspire you to live your purpose and regain your focus. And now, here's your host, Shamaya Reed.
Hey, welcome to I Am Refocused Radio. We are here once again, and today we are going to talk to Mayor of Live Oak, Ms. Mary M. Dennis, and she's been on the show a few times, so some of y'all might be familiar with her. But for the ones who don't, I'd like to welcome her to the show and say, how are you doing today?
Hello, I am doing great. Thank you so much. And thank you for having me. You're right. I've been here several times, but I always look forward to spending time with you. So thank you again for having me.
And for those who don't know a little bit about you still, let's give them some details about who the Live Oak Mayor Mary Dennis is.
Well, I tell you, I tell people I'm just a person who really cares about people, that really, truly wants to serve. And I've known this for most of my life, I think since I was about 9 years old, that I wasn't sure what my life was going to be, but I knew it would be about serving others. And so I've been very blessed on this journey. I am, in fact, this past May, I just took office for my 10th year, start my 10th year as the mayor of the city of Live Oak. So I'm super honored and excited about that. And even though 10 years has probably been a long time for some, I feel as if it was just the 10th day. That's how excited I am about the job that I get to do and the service that I get to give to the state of Texas and most particularly to the city of Live Oak. So I started on city council, worked there a couple of years, and then came over to the seat as mayor, as I said, 10 years ago now, and just have been very blessed in the people that I work with, our city council. We've got a great city council, a wonderful group of men that are serving the city alongside our city manager, Scott Wayman, who's doing a super fantastic job, and particularly during this COVID experience that we are having at this time. But just very, very honored and blessed to be serving in this capacity.
We're not strangers to what's going on with this pandemic and COVID-19. We all are doing our best to adjust to the times. What have you seen that you have practiced for the city of Live Oak to help businesses get through this safely?
Very good question. And I said in the very beginning that there has not been a playbook for COVID. You know, we can generally go to how to run city governments, you know, how many people you need in the fire department, how many police officers you need. But this COVID experience has been new to all of us. So there's not been a playbook. So much of what we're doing has really been coming from us just kind of feeling our way through this. And I think that's even true from the federal level. So we have been very fortunate in that we are, because we are in the city of Live Oak is in the county of Bear, Judge Nelson was being our county judge. He gives direction to Bear County. So many of the directives and orders that we have received for the city of Live Oak come through Judge Nelson Wolf. Our obligation is to get the orders out to our residents and our businesses and to make sure that they understand what is being asked of us. In the beginning where we had to take down the basketball courts at our park, I was like, oh no, but we had, you know, I understood that that was what we had to do. So many of these things have been uncomfortable for all of us. However, the safety of our residents is paramount and the safety of our employees is very important. So we all have to do our part in being safe and keeping each other safe. And I believe, and I know in my heart that we will get through this.
When you see the process of people still trying to celebrate the holidays differently, of course, what are some of the things that you're seeing in Live Oak, Texas?
Because safety to me is the most important thing, because we want to come through this. I think even for Thanksgiving, for many of us, it was a different look at our, you know, in our homes than, you know, we have 30, 40 people in our homes, you know, in the past. But even this year for me and my own personal family, my children and my grandkids live in Nashville, Tennessee, and we were unable to be together because we just felt that it was the right decision for us to make. So we did a Zoom call and we played games and just kind of made it work over, you know, over that platform. So it's going to look, I believe Christmas is going to look the same for many of us who have decided for the health of our family members and our friends that the separation is the best, you know, option that we have right now because of the challenges there are when we all gather together. So I think that, of course, no one wants to do it because we know I love to hug folks and, you know, have fun and laugh and talk. We've got to get through this to be able to get to the other side. And so I think the sacrifices that we have to make in these areas has to be what is most important.
And also for those listening, we're talking to the mayor, Live Oak, Ms. Mary M. Dennis. And when you see how people have adjusted, what are some of the success stories that you have found in Live Oak, Texas, of businesses adjusting to the times?
That's a great question. And that's one of the things that I am probably most proud of. And that early on, our Economic Development Corporation, we came together and we said, what can we do to help our businesses here in the city of Live Oak? So what we decided to do were to give grants of $5,000 to our businesses. And it was a very simple application. I think we voted on it one day, and about 2 days later, we had rolled out the program. So many of our businesses were able to take a part in that grant and were able to pay their rent or their employees or whatever they needed to do. And although it wasn't a large sum of money, we got so many letters and emails from our businesses saying how much they really did appreciate that support coming from the city of Live Oak. So I was very proud of our city council and our economic development department, and also Donna Louder, who heads that division, in getting that application to the businesses and getting the monies and the funds to all that applied. And we were very proud of that. And so, of course, everyone's had to kind of reset, readjust, and you're absolutely right how the businesses, many of the restaurants had to go to no indoor dining. I know now through the governor's order, we are at a 75% occupancy. And so they've been able to move up from the 25, 50, and now to the 75. And going forward, I don't think any of us really know for sure how this is going to play out. But it's amazing to me how the businesses, I mean, they're very innovative. They're like, okay, let's take this thing outside. And so one of our businesses, they started doing an event out in the park, taking their product out there and doing exercise classes. And so I think that that's the brilliance and the strength of our country and our community, is that in hard times, we're like, okay, that didn't work. Well, let's come up with another plan and make it work. And so just seeing neighbors, you know, helping each other, people calling to check on each other, it's been really a joy to see the strength of our community and coming together.
And people want to check for updates and find out what's going on in Live Oak, they can go visit liveoaktx.net. That's liveoaktx.net. Or they can go to facebook.com/cityoflivevoteTX. When we all know, too, that events have been closing everywhere. So there's going to be different ways of getting people excited, because we still have the opportunities to do things. We just have to do it slightly differently. What do you know, if you can share with the audience, how will people in Live Oak be able to have a little fun, but safely, or just updates for the future?
Well, I like the way you put that, that we're still going to do it, just do it safely. And of course, this was our 60th year as a city, and we had planned a huge celebration for our 60th city anniversary. Of course, that plan was, you know, has had to be put on hold, but we're hoping in the near future to be able to do a huge celebration to celebrate our city being 60 years old. Some of the things that we have been able to have, we were able to have a very successful Halloween event in the park where people just drove through in their cars, and we were able to hand them a bag of candy and a couple of items from the city that we would have given out during the celebration. So we, you know, that was kind of our B plan. For Christmas, however, it's going to look a lot different for us. We normally have a big event with the Santa Claus coming in on the fire truck and taking pictures and Santa talking to the kids. So that's going to look a little bit different. We were able to still have the kids send their letters to Santa and brought those to the city hall. So we got all of those letters to the kids, Santa. Now, what Santa's going to do with them, we're not sure. But we are going to have Santa up in front of our Justice Center, and he will be there. And the families had to call in to make an appointment to be able to come by and get a picture with Santa. That's how that's going to look for us this year. But nevertheless, we can't forget the reason that we have Christmas, the reason that the world celebrates Christmas, and that's because of the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And so let's keep that in mind as we're going forward through this difficult and trying time, that the reason that we really have Christmas is because of Christ.
You as an individual, we know you love to cook And sadly, you won't be able to pass that to a lot of people in heavy traffic. But are you still going to cook?
I certainly am. My kitchen has been, it has been nonstop. I have two ovens in my kitchen, and they have been getting a lot of work out during these last couple of months, because cooking brings me such joy, and sharing it brings such joy for me. So my neighbors are probably getting all fat because I'm not eating any of it. So taking it to the fire station and the police station and up to the administrative offices and to our neighbors here in Live Oak. So I have been cooking up a storm, and I still plan to keep that going.
Once again, you listen to I Am Refocus Radio, talking to Mayor of Live Oak, Texas, Ms. Mary M. Dennis. And before we let you go, what do you believe is the message you would like to give to the audience listening right now to encourage them to keep pressing forward and never settle and give up?
And that's what you just said. You just took the words right out of my mouth, is that we have to press through. We can never give up. We've had many challenges before, and we'll have them again. But we take those challenges and make opportunities. How do we take what's been given us? It's like that thing about taking the lemons and making lemonade and adding some sugar and making it something good. So I just want to encourage everyone to just kind of look out for your neighbors, call your family and friends. I think this is a good time for all of us to reflect on what's really important. Sometimes I think we've taken so much for granted, our being together, our being able to hug and touch each other. But we can't do that now, but we can in a way that maybe looks different. And so just take time to call someone, check on them, encourage them. Keep yourself encouraged, and remember, know that through this difficult time, that this too shall pass, that we will get through this, but we will come out stronger and better together.
Once again, having the privilege to talk on this exclusive interview with the one and only mayor of Live Oak, Texas, Ms. Mary M. Dennis. It's always an honor to have you on the show, and I appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule to have some exclusive updates on what's going on in Live Oak. So once again, I want to thank you for being on Army Focus Radio. And before we sign off, what would you like to tell everyone who's listening right now?
Merry Christmas and a very, very happy new year. Be safe, be kind.
And once again, like we say on every single show on I Am Refocus Radio, keep God first, stay focused, and peace.